Hello everyone, the topic of today's debate is should prostitution be legalized in our country, India? I repeat, the topic of the debate is should prostitution be legalized in India? So many of you are not aware that prostitution is already legalized in India, but that is under certain circumstances and it's partially legalized, not fully legalized. So yeah, just a second, I got a request. For the motion, according to me, prostitution should be legalized in India. And I have a friend, Vishesh, who will be joining me and he will be talking against the motion, which is prostitution should not be legalized in India. And mainly we'll be talking about the good and the bad impacts that we're having because of this industry in our country. So I think Vishesh has already joined us. Let's just wait for a few seconds for him to get connected. Yeah, meanwhile, the viewers are fully allowed to add their opinions and viewpoints in the comment section. Vishesh, are you here?
Yeah, I'm here.
All right, so I would like you to start first.
Okay, so in my opinion, prostitution, as we all know that prostitution is legal in India, but the thing is, even though it is legal in India, pimping and opening of brothels, it's abolished by the law, and any individual who is into opening brothel, semi-brothel, a place where prostitutes are being kept forcefully or without any sort of physical force is illegal. However, according to me, prostitution should be illegal in India because it's a business, but it's not being taxed by the government. And even though a lot of revenue is generated, we cannot actually keep a track of how much money is being made in this sort of business. Apart from that, a lot of people, even guys who join, who fall for prostitution, they just become prostitute or a call girl or a call boy just because they need money. They are in dire need of money, and sometimes their own situation, their own personal finances and situations just keep them going that they should become prostitute for their whole life. And once they get in, it's really hard for them to get out of that trap because a lot of people are involved in it. And many times if someone gets involved in some sort of prostitution,
I'm totally against the fact that the people, the young kids, basically I would say kids who are forced into prostitution, I'm totally against that. But see, if you say that, it should not be legal, then there is no guarantee. It's not even possible that, if it was not legalized, this industry won't be there. Definitely, it will be there, under the dark world that we're having, it will be there. So it is definitely better that we, put some limitations. You were talking about the tax. So the government should lay out certain methods, certain ways in which the, tax, it can be obtained, in which the prostitutes, whether it's a guy or a girl, should be, educated more about the kind of, bad effects that it can have. Suppose the STDs or, the other things. Because generally in such an industry, only the people who are not very educated, who are below the poverty line, get involved. Right. So instead of, banning it, we should just, teach them. We should, put certain laws in which this can be, brought down in a very good manner. So that is what I feel.
I think if you know that division in India is pretty easy. A lot of individuals make a ton of money, maybe around the annual income might be about 2 or 3 per annum, and there are high chances that they are paying taxes less than about 4 or 5 lakhs. This is because tax laws and tax evasion is pretty easy. And if you're talking about taxing this prostitution, people who pay to prostitute, I think it's not possible as for now, because we are in India and we are not in Las Vegas where everything is taxed and girls have.
All right, so we need to, if we keep that mentality that this is not Las Vegas, then, our country will never develop. We need to change that. We need to lay down the rules. We have to do that. And if it is not happening, we have to force down the rules. Because if it is not legal, I repeat that there is, no guarantee that this type of industry, won't be there. It will actually get worse. So it's better that, it should be legalized. It's better. That would be better.
I think, like, even if this thing is legalized, there won't be any sort of impact on the economy. Apart from that, there will be economy will be hindered in a negative manner, because in Hinduism and according to our own different cultures, is not the right thing to do.
Our country is such, you know, our country India is known for its cultural diversity and all those things. But because of all those bullshit, you know, our country is not developing. Like, you must have heard the recent news in which, you know, the government, you know, stated that the government will remove the word sex from sex education. So, sex is made like a taboo in our country, India. So, we need to change that. And suppose, like, you know, just imagine a hypothetical situation in which prostitution industry is not there at all. Just imagine, okay? There's no such thing as prostitution that exists. Then we'll have to understand that being a human being, when we reach a certain age, you know, when we grow, we reach a certain age, you know, be it a man or a woman, sex becomes a part of life, okay? And suppose this kind of industry is not there, the person who don't have control over their sexuality would get indebted to indebted into rapes. And that is why, you know, I think that if it is not legalized, if that industry is not there at all, the rape cases would increase, which is really a bad thing. So we should not really focus on the economy. There are many aspects that, you know, we should keep in mind. And that is why I strongly support that prostitution should be legalized, and the sex that we're having, the sex education and the whatever taboo and the myths that we're having related to sex should be eradicated totally. Then only our country can develop, because developing doesn't really, you know, mean economy, doesn't really mean infrastructure. It actually means the mentality, you know, it is totally based on the mentality.
Okay, so you're saying that like developing economy like that. Let me tell you that Netherlands and US have legalized this prostitution in their certain states, and Netherlands are fully like legal to be a prostitute, and nobody is gonna be hired.
Right, right.
So, but cases are there, and according to me, they are developed in India, and still rape cases are there even after legalizing prostitution.
Yeah, I don't think even after legalizing, because we are not having proper laws, and still now it is taken to be, you know, really a very bad thing. Because what I feel is that an industry is an industry. Let it be a pornography industry, let it be a prostitution industry. An industry is an industry. And once the, you know, already, see, you know that it is already legal. So once we, you know, like kind of polish those laws, we add up more laws, we do regular checkups, you know, in the industry which are going on, then I think the rape cases will definitely decrease. You know, it will be decreased. And if it is not there, the chances, you know, I would say that it would increase to up to 50% in our country, the rape cases.
Okay. I think you might be getting emotional with bigger. Like, you cannot just regulate that percent of the rape cases will drop if you...
I'm not just relating the rape cases to prostitution. There are certain, like, there are many other factors too, but then this this factor actually plays a very good, like, you know, role. It puts a great impact. Are you there, Vishesh?
It has certain hindrances to an individual's mental health, because a lot of prostitutes in India, to be more specific, I'm talking about the places near Calcutta, they are not mentally stable. So I think the life of a human is more important than legalizing the prostitution and everything. So I think legalizing prostitution is a bad idea. And
about, you know, they're mentally disturbed and all those things. See, I already stated that most of the people who, you know, who are voluntarily into prostitution are basically from a very deprived background. They're not properly educated. They are below poverty level. So it is not possible for us to totally eradicate poverty from our country, because many people, you know, many people in our country are below poverty level. So if they are voluntarily into such an industry, I think, you know, it is their job. Because see, if you think about pornography, you know, if a person, like, a person cannot be forced, right? You know, they are forced, right? So that should not be supported. But the people who are voluntarily into it, you know, they should not be stopped, because it is totally up to them what kind of work they choose. So this is also a work, actually. So it totally depends on the people if they are actually, you know, willingly involved in such thing. And the people who are forced into it, you know, against them, like, serious action should be taken. But the people who are there in that industry by themselves, then, you know, I think it's, like, okay to be there. It's not a bad thing.
I don't think that there are people who just voluntarily go into prostitution because
I have read many articles and have come across like many people who are into such industries, by their own choice because they did not, get any other option. So, like, getting into such an industry by working, whether it's a, whether it's being a sex slave, working in that industry, that is better, or just sitting on the road and begging, that is better. You tell me.
I think begging on the road is better because selling your soul, selling your body for the money is not the right thing to do. I'll tell you one thing, people who live on streets, like a couple of people who live on streets, hate themselves, and they, a lot of individuals have been to Harvard.
This is exactly the mentality that I want to change because, that is their body, their soul. So it totally depends on them. We don't have any right to, judge them. We don't have any right to point out on them. So it's totally up to them. And this is exactly the thing that I want to change with Indians because, this is not a very big deal, Just you lay down certain conditions, you lay down certain rules, and then, it won't be a bad thing. And the crimes that we are facing, those things should be eradicated, not the industry as a whole.
I guess you haven't been to Calcutta, I guess. Roam around the streets, 5 or 6 year old girls are dragged into prostitution schools, and that's a kind of bad thing. And
First of all, I've been into Calcutta, and in fact, I've been to 20 states in India. I've been to many places in India. The thing is, I'm repeating that the kids, the small kids who are forced into such industry, they should be protected, the people who forced them, they should be jailed, in fact. But the people who are voluntarily there, they should not be, punished in any way. So that can happen only when we legalize the process. That is the thing.
See, something won't be beneficial, it's similar to marijuana. Marijuana has certain medical effects, and it's in fact used in a lot of medicines. It cannot be legalized because it makes an individual paranoid. Same thing goes with prostitution. If prostitution, let's say prostitution is legalized in India, to go to a random general store to get chocolates and something, so it will be accessing the sex is will be that easy.
Are you trying to say that if this industry is not legalized, the kids won't be dragged? They won't be dragged, they won't be forced, and then these kind of crime won't happen. The substance abuse won't happen. Are you trying to say that?
Yeah.
See, in a country, it's not possible. See, you ban something, even if, in between some porn websites were born, but still, India, like Indian people, they accessed it, right? So if we ban something, it's not that, we will we will very nicely, we will follow that thing. It's not that. Indians are not that, like that. Many people in India are not like that. This industry will still run in a very private way, but this industry, there's no possible way in which, we can totally destroy this industry or eradicate this word from the universe. It's not possible at all. So even if it is not legalized, this will be there. It's like you don't legalize it, this will be there.
But talk about pornography, right? See, in China, Google and Facebook is bad, but people use VPN and proxy networks to access.
It is banned because the government does not want them to use it. Simple. But then still they're still using it. That's my point. The government doesn't want them to use it, but then they're still using it. Even in Pakistan, Facebook is banned. But then I've got many friends in Pakistan who have the access. So even if we ban this kind of an industry, it will be there. So it's better if we take some actions. That would be much more beneficial.
It's not the right action, I guess. I guess legalizing is not the right action.
See, apart from legalizing, do you really think that we have any other option?
Yeah, we actually have a lot of options. I think the government should take some steps to educate these women. Actually, the government has some sort of rules. Like there are steps for ex-prostitutes who want to educate their children, who want to educate themselves, who want to get out of prostitution circles. There are some sort of rules, but the government can implement these rules
only if this industry is legalized. Because if you're saying that if the prostitute wants his or her children to get educated, So that opportunity can be given only if that prostitute is a legal prostitute. That is my point. Understood? And it is not possible for a country like India to educate every person that is there, you know, educate everyone. It is not possible. We don't have that much of a capacity. So it's better, you know, whatever industry they're engaged in, whatever it is, for that industry, you know, the government should support them. That is like my point.
Government supporting prostitutes. Prostitutes are legal, but brothels are not legal.
Yeah, so see, that is exactly our topic. See, we are basically talking about the bad and the good impact, right? It is already legal. See, it is already legal. So I'm just talking about whether, you know, the things that can happen if it is not legal. So that is what we are discussing about. Although it is already legal, so.
And if brothels are made legal, so imagine like a couple of decades ago, India didn't had any liquor shops, and people were very excited that, okay, we have a liquor shop in our place. So eventually what actually happened, a lot of drunkards started showing up there, and a lot of nuisance activities were started happening. Now we are on the verge of and liquor shops are on the verge of extinction.
Humans are like that. If you restrict something, they are provoked to that thing, you know, a lot. Suppose there's a kid, you ask your kid to not, you know, to like, if you take the phone from your kid, and if you ask the kid, you know, not to use the phone, he will be provoked more. He would like to, you know, see, okay, what is there in the, you know, phone. He would get more provoked. So when you ban something like that, you know, if you just, you know, put some banners, you ban it, then people are more provoked. So again, it leads to the things that I was talking about earlier, the rape cases. So I think this should not be banned. People should be educated about it. You know, people should be given proper education while they're in school, and the people who have the opportunity, who are from a very well-to-do family, should also be, you know, be involved in understanding the concept of such an industry, and this should be there from a very early childhood. And the local people who are not having any like access to education and stuff, the government should, you know, take out proper campaigns and then teach them about such things. So I think that would help a lot. Because, like, if you don't make it legal, like, if you just ban it, then I think that's not the solution. That is not the proper solution.
See, let's say brothels are legalized in India and prostitution is fully legalized in India. Right. Imagine a brothel opened up in any sort of place, and it will still be a shady place because random creepy people will show up there to, you know, to perform their physical needs.
Okay. See. Like, suppose you talk about the wine shops. Whenever a particular wine shop has to be opened, we have to take a particular sort of license from the government. And if the wine shop has to be opened in front of some school or, you know, in front of some college, the government does not allow that. You know, it is at a certain distance. So if you need a particular license for a like prostitute industry, then I think you should, like, you know, take a license, and that license should have certain conditions that, you know, it should not be, you know, opened up in front of a, you know, a temple or something, or in front of a school or something. Like, proper rules should be there, and those are already there, I think. So legalizing won't affect it anyway. Legalizing will, in fact, like, enhance it in a like certain way, enhance it to run in a certain way.
So if prostitution legalize, you know what actually will, a lot of individuals will turn to prostitution instead of working hard and doing the legalizing the prostitution is a bad idea. And
what industry a person wants to work, that is totally like, you know, it depends on that person. If I am educated, I am having enough money, if I am getting a, you know, engineering degree, I would prefer to be an engineer. But if there's another person who does not want to do this, who wants to get into an adult industry, he has the right to do that. These are the human rights. This is the right to choose. Okay. So I think that the right of choosing, it cannot be banned. So if it's a person's choice, then I think that person should definitely go for it. Vishesh, are you still there?
A prostitute, and according to this legalization of prostitution and brothel is a really bad idea, because see, any kind of business which is legal in India should provide some sort of value to the government, and I don't think economically or internationally it will be helpful for Indian government or for India to legalization, because it won't be any good. It won't bring any kind of thing to the table, and it won't be bringing.
This industry is already there. So even if, see, you're talking about economy, even if the benefits are not there, then at least we will have a control over the things that are going on. So if you legalize the process, you get the control. So the government will have the right to, you know, like check it. The government will have certain rights. So legalizing is like, you know, really good. And now I strongly feel that our debate is not going into any direction. So I would like the viewers to like, you know, put up some comments or inbox in the Instagram Vishpi page, so that they can add up their opinions. What do you think, Vishesh?
We should wind up. And so let the viewers share their opinions as well.
And I would request the viewers and, like, you know, everyone who doesn't have used Vishpi, that you can download this application. It is a very good application in which you get the chance to, you know, like, add your own opinions. So you can also share your own opinions in videos on this topic. So stay tuned, guys. Thank you.